It was just a roll in from Jerix there. A good slow and a dagger from Anna. He did get around the... Yeah, she generally will be, especially in the laning stage like this. Like, she's one of the worst base damage heroes, one of the worst base set heroes. Limp on the mid lane does end up getting killed finally. It's going to be a tough game if things keep going weak.
Up top, there is going to be another rotation in by Jerax. We were talking about this phenomenal pick on the Earth Spirit. And that is not going to be an Omni Knight going home to see his family. Another kill here. Oh, we got a double damage quap. It's going to be X'd up by Hanskin, brought back into the torrent. Do they have the lockdown necessary?
No.
Well, they do.
Yeah.
That's going to be Limp getting some revenge, but having to split the XP a little bit there. And you look at the Legion already at 24, so S4 going to be stacking up a little bit more ferociously than Lota for now.
And looks like Jerix wants to try to get the kill. He's level 4 here.
And a couple more swats, and that's going to be a quick kill for Jerix. He's going to go ahead and get X'd up. Just Hanskin down bottom. We are going to have a stun coming back in. That's going to be a really nice kill set up onto that Legion Commander. Good work on Alliance rotating in what they need, but there's going to be the Quap coming in, unloading the ult. Easy kill onto the Crystal Maiden, and now it's just Limp running away. Wants a little more damage. Meanwhile, down bottom, we've got a scuffle. S4 is going to go ahead and get shackled as Limp is going to be able to TP in time. There is going to be a boat coming in onto the X. S4 dodging out a little bit of damage, but gets blown up by that Omni Purification.
X is just amazing at guaranteeing setups here.
That's the kind of drafting elimination mode can bring you.
Look at he's got 4 points in Fatal Bonds too. This could be so good for them.
Dropping down that Golem, it looks like this Omni is just going to completely get comboed down. He's got to Purify if he needs it, but he will still get focused. We've got the Queen of Pain getting very low, focused down by the tower shots. Warlock healing him up, and now Hanskin's going to get chased down, as well as Limp. They're moving backwards. There's a TP in from the Crystal Maiden, but what can she really do? She's got her ult. She's going to try to get it off, but will get silenced. Now EGM chased behind the tier 2 tower. Meanwhile, Kunkka dealing with the wrath of Queen of Pain. It's two heroes going down right now. Sven, the only survivor, walking out of his base. That was an unfortunate pick.
Going to the Legion Commander, or Ganks from the Quap.
TP's in, coming in. Limp does not want to mess around, wants to go straight onto No-Tail, lands a really nice shackle, but they've got to watch out. The Warlock has his golems in the area. EGM on the back lines, they're going to pop the Aegis immediately. Can this troll get out of here? A boat going to be dumped onto his freshly respawned corpse. Meanwhile, S4 threatening on a duel. The golems are going to be dropped. S4 still thinking about the perfect initiation. Guardian Angel comes out on the back line. There is going to be the Warlock going down. Jerax rolling to safety. And the rest of OG bailing out. They do end up getting the X onto the Queen of Pain. She can't do anything about that. So Ana just going to try to run for safety.
Did go for the damage perk. A little interesting, but... maybe he could have gone for magic resistance. Hard to say though. Hands getting undergrabbed. No!
No-Tail doing a lot of work against the tower. Baits out the Kunkka. The duel going to be slower than he'd like, but look at that damage coming in from the golems. That's going to secure another duel victory for our Legion Commander. And now all of Alliance just scared up onto their high ground. The tier 2 tower goes down.
It's going to be fast. Even Troll, really rapid movement speed. So
we got Fight of the Neutral Creeps coming in as the rest of OG are still smoked up. This Mud Golem gonna be moving forward, and they go immediately for the duel on the Crystal Maiden. She never stood a chance. There is a Guardian Angel committed by the Omni Knight, but it's just not enough to save anyone here. The Golems drop down as the Guardian Angel ends. There's a Repel committed onto the Sven, but Lota is still taking a lot of damage. He's moving forward, wants to find a kill, and looks like Fly will get stunned up by the Mud Golem Boulder Toss. Oh, the Sven wants to stay alive so desperately, but just can't muster it, and Hanskin goes in, is able to cast the X, is Glimmer Caped up, but S4 is still hot on his heels. Is he going to be able to catch this up? There's a Shackle Blink in from Limp, trying to at least distract everyone, so maybe the Kunkka gets out alive. The kills aren't abysmal, the net worth isn't abysmal, but Alliance are so confined to their base right now. You see the initiation attempt coming in from Kunkka, but he's going to get focused down to half health, has to Glimmer Cape away. The Roche is still alive. Ana's still working on it. EGM going to ult from this cliff. Very, very nice ult. They're able to find the kill on the Legion. Legion has buyback, and now we are going to have Alliance make their way into the pit. Maybe a little bit ambitious coming out of this Windrunner. Meanwhile, Lota is going to grab the Aegis, the Radiant, kill the Roche.
No
this
way.
Is a huge play for Alliance. They're able to snipe down the troll from outside the pit. This is game-changing here. Alliance, they're on it. They're on fire. They've got the momentum, and Limp is going to keep chasing. Fly is going to go ahead, get X'd up, get Stormhammer, and they're going to be able to take out the Warlock as well. Jerax, the only one to get out of that fight. That was OG just tossing away that lead they had right there. Now that it has just been farmed down, EGM's gonna ping himself. Ana moves forward. Jerax wants to get the pick onto this easy little EGM and will be able to do so. EGM actually escapes with his life. Meanwhile, the rest of the fight happens over here behind this little cliff, and it is gonna be Windrunner going down. Crystal Maiden Bry's back, and that's going to be a very dead Sven. Lota just can't escape the slow of Warlock, and this is OG just showing their power in this game when they rotate together, when they get those pickoffs.
They can maybe bait with this by them knowing that their opponents have a ward. They might actually approach it. They don't, though. So if they get the ward killed.
Centaur going in, getting the information, Sven. Stormhammer gonna be disjointed. Limp actually blinks in, wants to start this fight, and it looks like Legion Commander will be focused down. He's gonna be saved temporarily. Guardian Angel comes out from the Radiant side. The BKB showing off from No-Tail. He's just running from the fight. Meanwhile, Ana waiting in the trees till it's time to reinitiate. Lota trying to move forward onto Fly, but Fly's got the golems back up. The duel's gonna be coming out from S4, trying to do some work, but S4 barely wins that duel. Gems are going to be on the ground. Jonas continuing to try to run from the fight. The rest of Alliance are just going to get easily focused down. EGM, though, almost dodges out No-Tail. Hanskin's Glimmer caped up. Lincoln's going to be popped all around. Troll tossing out more damage, and there's going to be almost a completely huge clean wipe.
It's only one more barracks to go, so Alliance is going to feel super pressured here.
Oh, Ana getting focused down. The rest of Alliance able to rotate very quickly to get on top of her. On the back lines comes in S4. He's got the BKB rocking, but he's now kiting five heroes. They've got Fly there, ready to drop golems if necessary, but they'd rather save him up. And now No-Tail comes in. There's the golems drop. They want to focus down Lota ASAP, because Sven is the key to ending this fight. But Fly, he's going to get four staff back and is maybe going to be able to escape. No, Limp with one more shot gets the kill. Blink back.
What's
as fine? Now Alliance are going to get cornered. They're wrapped around. They're fighting in a choke point, and that is not advantageous at all. GG called out. All right, I'll play it safe this time, but no guarantees for later on in the game.
The S4 is going to die right here, I think.
Yeah, he's going to get
low. He's super
dead. Ogre does not have his stun, just that little damage over time of Ignite. It should be enough. He's going to slap the ground.
Ooh, the evade.
That shot's going to miss, but the first blood does go the way of the Skywrath Mage. Nice little bounty going down there, and it looks like Jerax. He's going to be able to secure the kill onto Skywrath.
Oh,
is it
going to
cost him his life, though? Hanskin's actually the one getting really low here. And that's Jerax on Keeper of the Light level 3 securing a double kill.
Do a little bit better early presence, but it's not quite as good fighting-wise.
EGM going to go ahead and get charged. They have any vision after the fact. They do end up dropping the dust. But there's going to be a rotation coming from our Skywrath Mage. Do they have any sort of follow-up for this? Fly gets low, but Skywrath rocking the Clarity. Does he bring out enough damage? No-Tail, he does not have enough mana for the Chaos
Great
Bolt.
Self.
Fly's going to go ahead, try to channel up, get a little bit more health going for himself, and it looks like Jonas may have bitten off more than he can chew. He secures the kill on the Spirit Breaker. Can he actually secure the kill on No-Tail as well? This would be a huge play. No-Tail, he's running low on health. He has
six.
No mana, and that's going to be a double kill for our Skywrath Mage.
We'll see if they can get a kill. They go on S4.
Yep, Lota definitely looked to debut some of the stuff. They know that the split's not there. They're able to get a quick, easy kill. Track now onto No-Tail, so they've got vision of him. Just trying to clear out any sort of damage. But No-Tail is just sandwiched up. I mean, if he gets out of this, that's crazy. Lota's got his blade mail going, but they can still cut right through it. EGM now going to get charged as well. No-Tail is just manning up. Hanskin knows he's mana leaked. Can't walk too far. Oh my goodness. Chaos Knight, please. Illuminate's gonna cut apart that bounty hunter as well. And now Limp comes back in. No-Tail, he's so low health. He's still tracked up, and Jonas is gonna be coming back on through. Limp gets so low, but channeling up the March of the Machines, and it looks like No-Tail is gonna be going down. Tried to deny to the neutrals, but wasn't able to get it in time. Ooh, we're gonna have a tussle right now as Lota's just gonna get bounced back to the low ground by Jerax's Blinding Light. Fly gonna decide better of charging all the way into that. But Alliance seem to have got their go. Hanskin's gonna be going in, trying to initiate here. He's gonna get mana leak, he's pulled back, and Lota, he's gonna try to make this work for his team. They are able to get the silence off on the Storm Spirit, but now Lota has to go in 1v1 a Spirit Breaker. Even with Blade Mail up, it's looking grim. Ana's able to find that kill, and Fly is so low, goes down. But Skywrath Mage is able to get the silence off onto the Storm Spirit, sends off that little arcane after him, but not quite enough damage unless the wraparound from EGM is enough. There is going to be a sentry there, so EGM, he's fighting underneath Radiant Vision. He's going to get focused down. Ana just barely alive. Heat-seeking missile not finishing off S4 as well. These two heroes are so low. No-Tail, just a little bit of a misplay perhaps. Goes in, Reality Rifts Roche, and both of his illusions die instantly because they were targeted onto it, so loses that tank ability. And also, No-Tail opted to go in for the Manta without the armlet first. How do you feel about that?
We'll see after this fight. I'll talk about it.
Oh, track onto Fly.
They might go on Fly.
EGM's hanging around, and that is going to be a super dead bounty. All right, Lota's able to get two silences off, and actually Spearbreaker gets super low, finished off by a laser from Limp. Hanskin going to be chased down. Another heat-seeking missile comes in, but No-Tail is still hot on the chase. You've got Ana debuting that Lotus Orb, and now there's going to be a stun fest going on.
You got the multi.
Oh, another Blood Rite. No-Tail is able to get out, is going to be healed by Jerax's Illuminate. And this is going to be Ana jumping in and out of the fight. He's got stupid mana now from that Bloodstone with 18 charges.
And not to mention, you can get perks that will help your int level and things like that. There's more item builds you can fit in that
Fly,
give you
he's
some
going in. a little bit overzealous there. He's gonna die, but is it gonna start off a nice fight for the rest of his team? We'll see. As Ana's gonna get ruptured, he's low mana, he's gonna be able to pop off that Lotus Orb, so he's just gonna be sitting back, waiting out the rupture for the rest of the fight while the rest of the fight continues. We've got a silence on the CK. He wants to go back in reality. Instead, he's just going to try to TP home and get out unscratched. Similar story with Jerax. There's going to be TPs out every which way. And now it's just going to be down to S4 and the Storm Spear to try to focus down Hanskin. Or at least get out alive. Loda, he is racing. He is so fast because everyone's so low health. TPs in from the Skywrath. Ana, does he go down here? That is going to be Aegis popped. He's still got 21 Bloodstone charges. Bloodrite coming in. They really want to get Ana down. He is silenced. The Wind Panda coming in, though, keeping Bloodseeker out of the fight. The Ancient Seal making it so Storm Spirit can't get away. He has to suicide. And there's going to be a kill. S4 able to take down Hanskin. Can they actually finish this off in favor of OG? Looks like they're going to try as No-Tail comes back in, sitting under the Bloodrite. No-Tail does get silenced, but a charge coming in onto Loda. I think they should be able to get this Bloodseeker down, but the missile, rather the laser coming in from Blimp. S4 continues to pressure in, and this is just looking great for OG right now. One more hit will finish off Loda. He's charged as well. He's not getting out of that one alive. And it looks like it will be a complete wipe as EGM is the lone survivor. And that's going to be a godlike streak from our Storm Spirit.
You have to rupture somebody and close the gap here. They're going to try to kill Tinker.
He's going to blink away.
Oh, and, they see him. Oh, that was so cool. Did you see what happened?
I caught the very clip of it. I don't think
so,
I saw
Jerax,
it.
So Jerax recalled on the Chaos Knight, and as the recall ended, he blinked in, and Chaos Knight came with him.
Oh, nice. And now Ana's just going through. They are cleaning up Alliance. It looks like this top lane Arax is about to be taken.
This game's just over.
Again, we are in the Europe Finals. The winner of this game gets to go on and represent all of Europe going against NA. It's a big fight, but it looks like OG might be the ones to claim it as they're now working on the tier 4s after getting a second complete lane of Rax. Unless Alliance hold right now, it is looking grim.
It's looking really bad. They've got two dead heroes here. Chaos Knight uses his ultimate. He's got a heart picked up.
Zip in from Ana. This is against a Bloodmail Bloodseeker, or Blademail Bloodseeker. They just can't do anything. EGM is in the fountain. Look at this, a fountain diving Keeper of the Light.
I think that's why he didn't go Armlet, actually. It's kind of a bad idea against Bloodseeker to keep your HP low. Maybe a good choice. Oh, he goes back in.
Yep, No-Tail continuing to pressure as well. Godlike for the Storm Spirit. Storm Spirit's getting very, very low here. It will end up going down. And that's going to be Bloodseeker focused down once again. Loda cannot afford to die here, but he will. And that's going to be Skywrath getting low as well, hit by that Chaos Bolt.
They chase us.
I think it's over, Purge.
Well, I mean, it's getting kind of clumsy. Grabbing the eggs could change things.
Okay.
As the all depends on mana levels. I mean, it's close. There's four alive heroes for Alliance.
Ana's moving forward. There's a nice laser. The Blind's doing a little bit of work, but they are able to get the kill on the Bounty Hunter. The Ancient continues to fall. There's going to be that Blinding Light to force everyone out of the fountain. They've got the Zip on the Ogre as well. Coddle goes down, drops a gem. That's a big kill, but there's still creeps doing damage to the Dire structures. They
got
to defend now or it's all over. And Ana's zipping around. Can they actually lock him down? They do. They get the Storm Spirit down, but the Ancient is so gosh darn low, and they can't.